Java Hangout channel. Today I'm going to talk about factory design pattern. Factory design pattern is one of the creational design pattern. In previous video I explained design patterns are divided into three categories. One is a creational design pattern, second one is structural behavioral. So this factory design pattern is a part of a creational design pattern. Today I will demonstrate what are the benefits of factory design pattern, when to choose the factory design pattern, and how to implement the factory design pattern. I will give a small demo about how to implement the factory design pattern. So main advantage of this design pattern is it takes the responsibility of object creation logic from the client and it moves to the factory class. So that from this we will achieve more robust of our code, less coupled between client and producer, and easy to extend further logic. So in this scenario, client doesn't know about implementation of logic. So just he will invoke one method by passing a small input parameter, and client will get whatever he want. Logic completely abstract to the client, so that if you want to, we can modify in future without impacting the client. That is the more beauty and advantage of this factory design pattern. So when to use it? Is used when we have a superclass. It might be superclass is might be abstract class or normal class. It might be interface as well with multiple subclasses. So your requirement is client doesn't want to create the object of that classes. Just he will pass one input parameter. The client should get the appropriate subclass instance. In that scenario, we must go ahead with the factory design pattern. Thing is, it is very 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 important design pattern, and which is most widely used design pattern also. Not only in our projects, in real time projects, it is already used in so many frameworks like Struts 1.x, Struts 1.2, and Spring, Hibernate, even in JDK implementation as well. Okay, now I am going to show you pictorial representation of this factory design pattern. Let's take there is a one requirement. So loans, you know, right? There are several types of loans are available, like personal loan, home loan, commercial loan, vehicle loan, like different loans are available, and rate of interest for the loans vary between type of loans. For example, personal loan might be bit more than home loan. If home loan is 8%, definitely personal loan will be 10 to 11%. Commercial loan between depends upon the bank also, that is. Okay, so in this scenario, loan, we have to define one super class, whether it is a abstract class, fully implemented class, or interface. In my scenario, I used like interface as a super class in the sense interface only. So which contains the interest method, which returns the interest of a particular loan. So this is the super interface, and there are three implemented classes. So one is a personal loan, home loan, and commercial loan. So home loan rate of interest will be different, personal loan rate of interest will be different, and commercial loan rate of interest will be different. So this is the interface, these are the implemented classes. So if you, these classes can be invoked from the client class directly, that means client can create and utilize the functionality This is a tight coupling between client and provider. It is a time consuming performance, many related issues are there. So that this design factory design pattern suggests to avoid giving this control to the client, you can create one factory class which will take care the creation of this object creation of these classes like personal loan, home loan, commercial loan. So that your loan factory will take care of creation of object of these classes. And this is a factory demo is a client. Let's jump into the practical. According to the diagram, there is a one interface called loan, which contains the only one method, that is interest method. And personal loan is a class, home loan is a class, commercial loan is a class, which are implemented same interface, that is loan interface. Personal loan, it is a class which is implemented this loan, right? Personal loan implements loan. So loan contains one method, that is interest method. It is overridden in this personal loan. And personal loan interest is 12%. And home loan also implements this loan interface, so overridden this interface. Home loan interest is 8%, 8 means 8%. Commercial loan also implements this loan and overridden this interface method. Loan percentage is 11%. So now according to this factory design pattern, we have to define one factory class, that is loan factory. So this is an independent class, it doesn't implement any other interfaces or classes. So which contains the get interest, which is taking a string as an input parameters. This string loan is a loan type. If you want to, you can change also Alt Shift R loan type. So within this one, all these three classes, personal loan, home loan, commercial loan, classes objects are created. So if input parameter is personal, that means personal loan object is created. And if input parameter is home, then home loan object is created. Commercial loan object. If input parameter is none of these or null, then straight away it will return the null. So this is the implementation of complete implementation of a factory design pattern. Now let us go with client. Client is nothing but this is the factory demo. Factory demo, which contains the main method to execute this class. So loan factory contains one static method, that is get interest. Get interest, it is a static method. That's why by using class name, we are invoking this interest method and passing personal. That means it will go to here. It will check input parameter type. What is the type of input parameter, whether it is personal, home or commercial. Since user is passing the personal, that means this first condition is satisfied, right? So it will return a personal loan instance here. So personal loan interest is 12% according to our implementation, 12%. So when we invoke this interest method, we must see 12%. So we can execute this one, right click on this one, run as Java application. See, interest rate is 12%. If you want to see home loan rate of interest, then pass this home. You will get to know the interest rate of this home loan. So according to our implementation, home loan is 8%. If you pass commercial, you will get a commercial loan rate of interest. That is 11%. See, 11%. This is the one. So if you want to see which class is being executed, you can override the two string method. So I'm going to override two string method. There is a shortcut, right click, and source. If you see among these options, generate two string method. It will prompt to choose the which method you want to implement. So methods in existing method. See, it automatically overridden. You no need to write this one public string to string, which is a method available in a object class. So personal and interest it will be like that. You can override in home loan also. Right click, source, generate two string method, choose the method. Commercial loan as well, right click, source, two string, select the method. See, it will, if you have any doubt, you can read, already instructions are there here. Select fields or methods to include in the two string method. If you, whether you want to this particular class methods or inherited methods, just I want to this particular class method, that's why I selected checked this checkbox methods. Click on OK, automatically method will be generated. Now see, I will comment this one. Now just I passed commercial. So commercial loan class will be created and given to this factory demo class. Let's see. Right click, Java application. This is the one. So interest rate. So nothing is there, right? You have to print the that instance of that particular class. Now right click, run as Java application. See, commercial interest is 11%. For example, if you pass personal, you must get the personal loan interest. See, loan type is personal loan and interest is 12%. This is the one. For example, if you don't pass anything, just pass empty string, that means in loan factory method there is no condition, right? Only personal loan, home loan, commercial loan. We have three types of loans only. If user by mistake enters only empty string, then it doesn't satisfy any of these conditions, it will return automatically null. See, loan type is null, like that. Okay. That's all about factory design pattern. If you have any doubts, you can comment, and I will constantly go through that comments. I will reply back you guys. Thank you so much. If you don't subscribe my channel, please subscribe my channel. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching this video.